The transition to the Common Core begins with the alignment of resources. Teachers within the Archdiocese will be provided with a wealth of resources to help them deconstruct the Common Core standards and transform their teaching. Initially, teachers will receive materials to support the teaching of English. Materials for math instruction will follow shortly afterwards. In this section, we will present and discuss the various materials teachers can expect to receive. The following section of this DVD will focus more closely on unit planning. Teachers at each grade level will receive the following materials to support the transition to the Common Core: a grade-by-grade snapshot of the standards at their grade level. This document will display the standards from the previous year, the current grade level standards, and the standards for the following year. A year-at-a-glance pacing guide that lists all the standards at one grade level and the guidelines for which unit incorporates those standards, and approximately when during the year that unit will be taught. A reading strategies document that provides a variety of suggested strategies for actively engaging students with text. Unit plans covering approximately 6 weeks that provide the framework for the essential elements of unit planning, including suggested integrated activities and assessments. Exemplar lesson plans that will provide a model for the design of weekly and daily teaching plans derived from the larger unit plans. At this time, I'd like to welcome and introduce two principals who have joined us to discuss the professional development program. First, I have Catherine Pracht, who's principal at St. Stephen of Hungary, and Hugh Keenan, who's principal at St. Margaret of Cortona. Thank you both for joining us.
Oh, you're very welcome. Thanks for having us.
One of the materials that will be provided to teachers is a grade-by-grade snapshot of the Common Core standards in ELA and math. These documents will allow teachers to see clearly the standards assigned to their grade level, as well as the standards from a previous grade. This document will help teachers clearly see what students should have learned, what students are currently learning, and what students will need to learn in the following year. Kate, can you tell us how your teachers will find this useful?
Sure. Teachers at each grade will need to increase their awareness of the explicit vertical alignment within the Common Core. The grade-by-grade snapshot of Common Core state standards unpacks the standards by getting to the core concepts and grade-level limits, helping teachers recognize the progression of standards across grade levels that ensure college and career readiness is important so that they can recognize the critical role each grade level plays in preparing students for success. My teachers will find it helpful to look at the snapshot of the standards in their grade level and see the progression from what the standard was in the previous grade to what the standard will be in the following grade. The bolded information that helps distinguish what differentiates one grade from the next will be the basis for ongoing professional dialogue within my building.
Along with the grade-by-grade snapshot, Hugh, will come a year-at-a-glance chart, and that year-at-a-glance will provide the suggested pacing for a teacher for across the year. How do you see teachers using the year-at-a-glance chart?
We see the year-at-a-glance as a suggested pacing guide for standards and units that might be taught within a broad time frame. This will be a helpful tool for teachers because the Common Core standards include fewer standards, which require students to engage in more critical thinking, in-depth analysis, and application. Helping teachers determine the timing and pacing of the instruction to meet the standards is a critical step in the transition process. By providing teachers of math and literacy in grades K to 8 a year-at-a-glance pacing document, we hope to provide a level of support for structuring the year. The year-at-a-glance is flexible so that teachers can respond appropriately to the learning of the needs of their students. Teachers do not need to be worried about completing the mastery or finishing a particular unit at the exact time it appears on the year-at-a-glance.
One of the instructional shifts in the Common Core is really a new focus on nonfiction texts. Kate, as you think about your teachers and your students and the move to more nonfiction, and nonfiction comes with really increased complexity of text, what kind of support do you think your teachers will need?
The teachers will need a lot of support. And in order to engage students deeply with complex and challenging texts, teachers will need to use a wide variety of strategies during their reading instruction. Our teachers will be provided with a reading strategies document that will serve them as a reference guide. Not all of the strategies will be new to the teachers, but hopefully each teacher will gain at least one new strategy or be reminded of a forgotten strategy. I think what teachers will really find helpful is that the Reading Strategies document is not a standalone reference tool. The strategies are embedded in the unit plans and highlighted so that teachers will use the reference tool for more information on each strategy.
I plan to make use of this document with the teachers that I work with in my school building during faculty meetings for ongoing professional development. Because the Common Core state standards are so clear that all of us are teachers of literacy, this tool will be extremely helpful to teachers in all subject areas as they strive to integrate literacy into their instruction. I believe all teachers will benefit by studying these strategies so that they are prepared to help students engage with increasingly complex informational text related to specific content.
At the heart of the materials being provided to teachers are unit plans in both English language arts and mathematics. And one of those goals of the unit plans is to really highlight cross-curricular opportunities for teachers. As we move to unit plans, and you know, moving to unit plans requires somewhat of a sea change on the part of both teachers and principals and students. But as we move to those unit plans, what do you think is going to be so important about using those unit plans in relation to the Common Core?
The Common Core have an increased focus on nonfiction text and interdisciplinary approaches to instruction. In addition, here in the Archdiocese, we are committed to the integration of religion and Catholic identity. Students in all schools will need to be challenged to understand and apply new learning to a variety of real-world problems. During this transition year especially, teachers will benefit from tools to help them understand how to plan units of instruction that will allow for this kind of inquiry-based learning. The unit plans will encourage teachers to first focus on the standards and the outcomes for the student learning. Following that, they can incorporate and integrate a wide variety of resources, concepts, and disciplines to engage the students and achieve the standards. The unit plans will provide the framework for a new approach to the planning and delivery of instruction. I believe teachers will struggle, along with their schools, with exactly how to use their current resources, as well as materials referenced in these unit plans, as well as what they find on the internet. As a result, ongoing professional development and grade-specific discussions about implementing these units will be essential. I expect to foster those conversations within my own school building and take advantage of the opportunities provided by the Archdiocese of New York.
The unit plans cover a period of about 6 weeks and are really suggesting sort of at a high level what teachers should be doing during that period.
Right.
Kate, what do you think teachers are going to need to do to plan weekly lesson plans and daily lesson plans?
Teachers will be required to use the unit plan just as a framework of suggested activities to achieve the standards and the learning outcomes for students. Within that framework, there remains plenty of room for explicit skill instruction, grammar and language instruction, formal reading and math instruction, and teacher flexibility and creativity. A significant portion of the ongoing professional development planned for this coming school year will focus on developing teachers' abilities to integrate these various pieces and design weekly and daily lesson plans specific to their schools, their classrooms, and their own resources. In an effort to assist teachers at the beginning of this current school year, we will have provided lesson plans that are exemplars for each grade so that the teachers can have a model for future planning.
I want the teachers to understand that this transition is a process. We don't expect them ever to have all this perfected overnight. We intend the unit plans to serve as a framework and the lesson plans as exemplars. They will be supported with relevant professional development so that they will become comfortable making the unit plans their own and designing and delivering lessons that are increasingly aligned to the instructional shifts in the Common Core. Only when teachers are prepared to take ownership of those pieces for themselves will the benefits to students truly become apparent.
Thank you both for your time today. We appreciate it, and I know it's going to be a great school year.